Hi there, and welcome back to our Ultimate College Search Guide for Juniors. Today we're going to talk about going to college fairs and going on campus visits. Attending college fairs is helpful at any stage in your college search. They may be available at your school, in your town, or online. College fairs offer the perfect window shopping experience for students just looking to learn more about the options available to them. They are an easy way to get more information on schools you're interested in, maybe even find a college that you've never knew about, and where you can meet college representatives to ask questions, get materials about the school, and maybe score some merch. If you're not sure what questions to ask, we have the perfect article on our site that has 10 things you should ask a college rep at a college fair. The link for that will be in the description below. Once you have some schools that you're initially interested in, you should see them in person on a campus visit. There are four types of college visits: the traditional campus visit, an open house event, overnight visits, and virtual tours. You can learn about all these in-person options with our blog. I'll be linked in the description below. And we also recommend that you research these schools before you go on a tour and plan your questions for your tour guides. Questions that can't be answered with a simple Google search. On the days you decide to actually visit a campus, try to go on a day with great weather for the best experience. College fairs and visits should be fun, not stressful. Don't feel like you need to visit every school on your list, but take advantage of virtual tours for the schools that are far away or in places you can't travel to. We have a blog over on our website on how to have a great virtual campus tour experience. You can check that out in the link in the description below. We recommend you take notes during and after your tours about things you liked and didn't like. That way, when you come back to making a decision on which school you want to choose, you can compare your notes on each visit. And we recommend that you explore the local areas around the schools and see what's offered off campus, and to find out what kind of environment you'll be living in if you decide to live there on campus. One last blog we'd like to direct you to is from one of our student writers as they talk about their experiences with campus visits. The link for that will also be in the description below. If you like this video, make sure to check out the other videos in this series for juniors. We also have series for sophomores, freshmen, and seniors. So make sure to check those out to get all the information you need. If you like this video, make sure to like and hit that subscribe button. Also, click the bell button if you want to know when the next video goes live for a notification.